Hi everyone, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are going to discover how to play Ludo Club on PC, now you are able to display it on screen. We will be able to easily download and set up Ludo Club and play the game on a Windows computer with keyboard, mouse and big screen. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, to start we need to open our favorite web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the next URL I have highlighted in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen. You don't need to type anything, because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. Once clicking on the link, we arrive here on the site of LDPlayer. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we will launch to play Ludo Club on PC. As you can discover here, we access a number of advantages of using that emulator, custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and so on. Then, we will start downloading the Ludo Club by simply clicking on the button Download Ludo Club on PC that you can see here in green. We then click on this button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do is to run the executable file, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I reduced the browser to start to see the installation software significantly better. The installation software is quite simple. It is made up of a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will clarify what setup path really does. We basically simply click on it. And then we see that we display here the path in which the emulator is going to be placed. If we desire to change this directory, we have got to click on the Browse option, and we choose another directory and set up the emulator exactly where we wish. I am going to keep it as it is. I click on Back. And therefore I simply click on Install. At this point, before starting setting up this emulator, it's possible that it'll show us a number of computer software packages to install on the PC. As I do not want any of those computer software, I only click many times on the Reject button. Great, the installation commences and it is going to carry on along with the download of these megabytes that are represented on the computer screen. When you download it, it may be slightly more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go at a higher speed or slower, depending on your connection and depending on the speed of the emulator hosting servers. Today they're working extremely fast. The download is done, and instantly it continues on with the setup part. The installation will require more or less time based on the power of your machine. The more powerful it is, the shorter the software setup time and or vice versa. If we join the download and setup step, it usually takes quite a long time, so have patience. It has already completely finished on my side. At this point, the emulator has been started successfully. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar which will advance to the right, then when it gets to the end, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. The reality is the emulator has already been started, there for the first time. Not to mention LD Store is automatically started, which is actually a kind of Google Play. That isn't the most correct method to install the video game, and therefore I really don't recommend it, simply because occasionally the LD Store puts an out-of-date version of the video game. I am going to explain the way to install the video game making use of Google Play, and I recommend you to do it this way. The very first thing we must begin doing is to visit desktop by simply clicking on this icon that I am pointing out in green color. Before we continue on, as you can discover, it created a couple of software icons right here on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player icon will be the only one we are concerned about. Whenever we are planning to run Ludo Club on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this specific software icon and start the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything at all like that. Indeed, it is a software icon that we will certainly never make use of. We should do the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and which is to enter the Google Play Store. To achieve this we will go here to, System Apps, we click on. And we'll click on Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is launched. In this case we are required to sign in. Right now when we're on this page, we have to perform the next step which is imperative. So we mouse click on, Sign In. At this point it says, Checking Info. It might once in a while get blocked in, Checking Info, additionally it does not move ahead. In that case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it may almost certainly be repaired. At this point we are going to type our login name and password. The email has to be a Gmail email and its matching password. For example, you make use of the same email you are using currently in your YouTube account. Thus I am going to type my information and I will return when I have done it. That's all, data typed. Discover Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. We will agree to them all by clicking, I agree. After that, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also let it select it and it will produce a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We simply click on Accept. From now Google Play is launched as preferred choice and instantly. When the Google Play just isn't launched automatically and you don't know how to start it manually, I guide you towards how to do it. The first thing is to go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this app icon designated in green. Right now we go to the System Apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Well, we're right into Google Play. What we are going to accomplish now is go here to search for apps and games. Then we are going to research Ludo Club. So there we end up with it, we should click the first result. At this point we have the Android game. Let's simply click right here on the Install button that I'm displaying now in green color. This will start the software setup. Straight away it should download and install the game. It usually takes quite some time, or it may possibly be very fast. It all depends on our own web connection. It's actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting the following option that I'm showing in green, to be able to launch Ludo Club for the first time. I am by now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're about to click this new Ludo Club icon that was created. That game is started for the very first time. Now there we get it, I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the sound level of that emulator. It's right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume, this way we do not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is the very first one, we then click on this particular software icon that I am actually mentioning in green color. Thus maximize your display screen, coming with one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. In the case that we desire to launch the application in full screen, we click this app icon. And we might without a doubt be experiencing and enjoying the game app in 100% screen mode. To leave the full screen functionality, push the F11 key. So we would likely just play in regular display mode. From now, I am going to clarify you the computer keys mapping that is definitely extremely appealing. This strategy we will certainly be ready to use the game more effortlessly. The very first point is to click this application icon. And right now there you will be able to complete the recommended configuration settings. I can leave the default configuration, though if you like to improve it, you can do it without having problem. I take on this opportunity to say that once in a while, when commencing the Android game a black screen appears, if that is so and you notice the black display and the emulator does not start, I suggest a achievable alternative. We should go here, to the cogwheel. Inside the emulator options, in the advanced selection we have now a range of graphic resolutions. This is the resolution that we have now chosen automatically and we should select any of these other resolutions, for example that one down below. We opt for it and afterwards please click save. It may require us to restart the emulator and as soon as rebooted, most probably the emulator will start up and the black screen will disappear. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our own language. Once in a while it happens that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, as an example, in Japanese. So to set it in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. So here throughout many other options, we mouse click on the language drop down. We could decide on the language we like, Italian, Chinese, and so forth. Once the language is chosen, we would save, the emulator will restart, along with the video game, next time we run it, would as well be in the chosen language. At this time, there is another point that we have to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Gmail indicating that a completely new device has been connected with our Google account. It should ask us if we're the people who have connected that device. Absolutely, we must not worry, as the emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And then to see which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Be sure to go here to the model selection. And now we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for my video user demo. I anticipate you enjoyed it, especially that you found it informative. If that's the case, bring it a good like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer all your remarks, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment field below. You could also comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams occasionally, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click on any of those training videos that happens to be appearing on the computer screen and see you in the upcoming online videos. Bye.